Hello students, in the previous class we learnt about the whole numbers and the differences between whole numbers and natural numbers and predecessor and successor of the whole numbers and also number line and how to represent the whole numbers by using the mathematical operations on the number line. In that we learnt about the addition and subtractions of the whole numbers on the number line. Today in this class let us learn about the multiplications of the whole numbers on a number line and also a properties of whole numbers. First we learn about the multiplication on number line.
Minus 2, which is equal to subtract 5 minus 2, we get 3.
number 8 minus 1 which is equal to 7, we get whole number 1 minus 4. What we get here? Here we get the minus 3. This is also one property. We learn more. 1 minus 4 which is equal to minus 3. How will you get minus 3? You will learn in the next classes. Here bigger number is 4 and the smaller number is 1. When we subtract in these cases, we subtract bigger number to smaller number and put the bigger number here. Here we get the whole number. Minus 3 is a whole number? No, not at all. It is a whole number. So minus 3 is not a whole number. Now consider the multiplication. 3 into 4 which is equal to 2. When we multiply 3 with the 4, we get 12. It is a whole number. 2 into 3 which is equal to 6, we get whole number and so on. Next is considered, it is for divisions. 12 divided by 4 which is equal to 3, quotient becomes 3, we get whole number. 7 divided by 2, 7 by 2 is not a whole number. 6 divided by 3 which is equal to 2. 2 is a whole number. What you conclude in all these examples? Yes, obviously the whole numbers are closed under only in the addition and multiplication. This is the property of the whole number. The property is closure property. So the whole numbers are closure under only the addition and multiplication. This is the property of the whole numbers. The first property is closure property. Next we move on to the another property.